All right, gentlemen, I just got this handed to me. A hit-and-run felony at Ray's Cafe, 208 North Los Angeles. Got a patrolman on site. The coroner's on his way. Get down there, see if you can find any witnesses who can put a make on the car.
I need a drink. I got the goddamn chills again.
Skinnery says he'll sing, but if I guarantee he'll walk.
Isn't he the cop that won the medal and is solving all the cases?
They weren't even his prints, and he still confessed.
Someone gonna tell us what the hell is going
rude,
on?
But I ain't got time for talk.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes. Looks like the DA is going to press charges. Ana Rodriguez might do time.
I'll speak to the DA. She suffered enough.
I don't know, Cole. She's an easy make, and the DA likes convictions.
I'll convince him to let it go.
How you do that?
I'll give him something better.
Detectives, over here.
Cole Phelps, traffic. What have we got?
Thick as a white male, name of Lester Patterson. Walked out of the bar and into the street. Car hit over there and he ended up here. Dead on impact by the look of it.
Have you canvassed the area?
The only one with anything useful to contribute is the young lady over there. She lives above the bar. Name is Shannon Perry. No, it's not a stage name. 24 years old, she left Kansas to follow the yellow brick road.
Is that so?
We'll take a formal statement later. Right now, we're going to take a look around.
I see.
Phelps?
You should take a look at the body. Poor guy didn't stand a chance.
Landed on his face and ended up here. Car must have struck him from behind. Addison has life insurance. Notify next of kin. What have you got on the victim?
From all reports, he was intoxicated at the time of the accident. I'll know how intoxicated once I've done the autopsy. Looking him over now, I'd say he died on impact.
What about the chest wound? Isn't that inconsistent?
Very common in auto injuries. Look for a car with a prominent hood ornament. Those things are killers. Careful where you're stepping, Phelps. I don't come down to the station house and tap dance on your desk.
So the driver managed to brake before the impact.
Never the same, are they?
This blood is a long way from the body. The car must have been going like a bat out of hell. Body traveled a good 20 feet.
Knife covered in blood. Could be a steak knife. This is a hit-and-run case, Phelps. Anyone could have thrown away a kitchen knife.
In any case, we'll want tech services to scrub the alleyway before they bag the knife.
It's all yours, Detective. Miss Perry?
Yes?
I'm Detective Phelps. This is my partner, Detective Bukowski. Can you tell us what happened?
Well, I came to the window because I heard people arguing downstairs.
Then what happened?
I saw a car hit that poor man and knock him down the street.
What kind of car was it?
A dark red Lincoln Continental.
Did you see the license plate?
Only the first three letters, I'm afraid. 3C8.
Tell me more about the argument you heard.
Well, there were two voices. A man and a woman, that's all.
Why are you holding out on us, Miss Perry?
I'm sorry. I was hoping to tell my story to the newspapers. I'd like to get my picture in the paper. I'm trying to find work as an actress, and things are pretty difficult.
Cough it up, sister. We don't have all night.
The people arguing? They were husband and wife. I could tell by what she was yelling. Intimate things. Very embarrassing for the man.
Thank you, Miss Perry. Your information has been very helpful. You can go now.
You really think so? I hope you find that driver and put him away.
You certainly got away with the dames, Phelps.
Give it a rest, Bukowski.
Let's see what the patrons have to say.
I'll take the bartender. You work the rest of the room.
Courtney, come in. Have a seat.
Thanks, Doctor.
How are you finding working at the clinic?
It's, fine.
Are you sure?
Can I be honest with you, Doctor?
I would hope so, Courtney.
I was hoping that the therapy would be more beneficial.
Treatment can, unfortunately, be very long-term.
So many of the patients here are addicts, Doctor.
Many of them have been for years, Courtney. In the past, these people were condemned to sanatoriums. If we can reveal the root of the problem, then we have a chance to help them.
And until then, they stay sedated?
Do I detect a hint of reproach, Courtney?
I was expecting more, Doctor. I'm sorry. I don't mean to criticize.
Part of being a physician, Courtney, is learning to be patient.
How is it possible to keep so many of them on their medications, Doctor? Many of their addictions are illegal.
Oh, many things in life are gray, Courtney. What may on the surface appear to be illegal is actually of benefit to society at large.
I'm Detective Phelps of the LAPD.
How can I help, Detective?
Your name would be a good start.
Dudley Lynch. Hired help. I run the place when the owner ain't around.
Where is the owner?
He stepped out. Somebody had to take Lorna, Mrs. Patterson, home.
What can you tell me about the accident?
Not a lot. It was busy in here, and all I heard was the impact.
So what was he doing outside? It's against licensing regulations to drink on the sidewalk.
Esther and Lorna were having a fight. The owner made him take it outside. It was pretty ugly.
Do you know the victim?
Yeah. Lester Patterson. He's a regular here, or he was.
Not one of your favorite customers?
Lester was special, but not my kind of special.
Was Lester drinking alone?
No. He came here with his wife. She didn't seem too interested in the booze, though.
A witness overheard an argument.
Lester and Lorna. There's nothing like airing your dirty laundry in public, is there?
Why was Lorna Patterson in such a hurry to leave? What is going on here?
Lorna was pretty upset, so Leroy took her home. Lorna and Leroy are close. They've been talking about opening a new bar.
Leroy?
Leroy Sabo? The owner?
How long have Lorna and Leroy been talking about this new bar?
Who knows? I just served the drinks.
Bartenders hear all sorts of things. Are you gonna tell me, or do we have to start playing rough?
When Lester was drinking, he treated Lorna like dirt. He gambled away all their money. Lorna pitched Leroy about the bar. I don't know how interested he is.
Is Leroy doing well?
Hell no. The only thing keeping this place afloat are the poker games.
Thanks for your help, Lynch. I'm gonna need you to sign a statement with the patrolman.
Sure, no problem.
You get anything out of the regulars?
They weren't giving too much away. They liked watching Lester and Lorna go a few rounds every other day. And Lester was a fan of the love tap.
Operator, give me R&I.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, 1247. I need to run a partial license plate, 3 Charles 8. Cross-check possible Lincoln owners. Suspect vehicle is a red Lincoln Continental.
Just a moment, detective. Only one possible make on that license. Registered to a William Shelton, 738 West Temple Street.
Thanks.
Looks like we caught a break on this one.
Yes, rise and shine, jeans. Keeps your body physically fit. Your body requires iron daily. And what better way to give you the iron you need than rise and shine, jeans? Rise and shine, jeans. Rise and shine, jeans.
Lucky break getting a partial ID. These cases are usually dead in the water after 24 hours if no one comes forward.
Why don't they just stop?
You heard about fight or flight during the war?
Sure. Never back your enemy into a corner. That kind of stuff.
Right. Well, in a hit and run, the perp is already in flight. It's easier to keep going. It takes a degree of moral courage to stop and accept responsibility.
You're not as dumb as you make yourself out to be, are you, Stefan?
I didn't know I was making myself out to be dumb.
Right there.
William Shelton?
Yes?
It doesn't look good, Shelton. You packing your bags and making a run for it? You know why we're here.
Yes. The accident.
We've got witnesses who can put this car at the scene, not to mention the physical damage. This is open and shut, Shelton.
That coward thinks he can run from everything.
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on. Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
No wonder he killed someone, driving like this. Don't let that asshole get away.
Station. Go on, get after him!
All right, I give up.
Where's the driver's jersey?
Hold it right there, Shelton! How does a vehicular manslaughter rap sound, Shelton?
I hit him. I admit it, I just panicked, but it wasn't my fault.
What do you mean?
The guy jumped right out in front of me. He came out of nowhere. There's nothing I could do about it.
Why didn't you stop?
I've had accidents before.
That's it. We're done here. The DA is gonna love you.
They weren't all my fault. I'm a surveyor. I need my license for my job. There were people around. A woman and a man were standing right next to him. I thought they could get him to a hospital. I'm telling you, it's not my fault.
The guy is dead, Shelton.
You can't be serious.
William Shelton, you're coming downtown. We need to talk about a manslaughter charge.
Leave the coroner and the paperwork. Procedure can wait. We should probably go speak to the wife and let her know what's happening.
Okay. You become all heart at the prospect of paperwork, don't you?
I could save all year and not be able to afford that.
Do you believe him?
I believe he didn't mow down the victim on purpose. The rest of it stinks. His boo-hoo story about being a surveyor and not wanting to lose his license.
Well, we'll see how he enjoys surveying the same tiny room for the next 10 years of his life. You make a mistake, you face the consequences. You don't run off and hide like some little girl hoping it'll all go away.
People make bad decisions in the heat of the moment.
Well, I'd like to see him try that one on the judge. If he had time to clock who was at the scene, he had time to make a choice.
Yes? Hello?
Mrs. Patterson.
Is this about my husband?
We're investigating the incident, ma'am.
I see. Come in, won't you?
Can you tell me what happened?
What's to tell? He got hit by a car and now he's dead.
You don't appear to be too upset about the fact.
Lester and I met on a furlough in 44. We got married that weekend. People don't understand it now, but that happened a lot back then.
I see. So you probably did well to stick it out this long.
What's that supposed to mean, mister? I think it's about time you left. I have someone here, and
I beg your pardon?
You're gonna have to run that one by us again, sister.
It's okay, Lorna. I'm Leroy Sabo.
Well, well. Nice to see you're comforting the grieving widow, Mr. Sabo.
All right, wise guy. Do you have any intelligent questions you would like me to answer?
You can confirm Mrs. Patterson's story.
Lester lost at cards. He was kind of hard to control when he lost his temper. He turned without looking and walked right out in front of the car. It wasn't good.
What's your relationship with Mrs. Patterson, Mr. Sabo?
We're friends. Good friends.
You expect me to believe that?
Look, I was filing for divorce. Mental cruelty. Lester could be a mean son of a bitch.
And Lester knew about that?
No, I hadn't told him.
Well, hasn't this worked out well for the two of you? I feel almost bad for busting in on this little rendezvous.
How did the car come to hit Lester?
He walked straight into the path of an oncoming car.
You expect me to believe that, Lorna? It's all very convenient.
Gambling for Lester was like the needle for a hophead. He was yelling at me. He was yelling at the whole world. Kind of felt sorry for the driver. Poor guy had no chance.
You were arguing in the bar and on the sidewalk?
We were always arguing. So what?
Admit it. You were baiting him, pushing his buttons. We can easily get the full story from the regulars in the bar.
All right. Lester was playing cards out back. He lost, of course, and wanted back in. He suggested I earn the money on my back to get a mistake. That was the proposition he was putting to his so-called buddies. So maybe I was a little angrier than usual. Let's just say I took exception to his idea.
The bartender said that you and Leroy were planning to go into business together. Can you explain how you'll get the money to do that?
I have a little money saved away.
You're being economical with the truth, Lorna.
You want to back that up, little man?
You increased the premium on Lester's life insurance. GI insurance policies have a $10,000 payout.
It was Leroy's idea. Lester lived on the edge. He was always getting into fights, crap games, pinochle, you name it. Turns out it was good advice.
It speaks to motive and premeditation, Lorna.
You're forgetting the hit-and-run detective.
You and Mr. Sabo have an interesting day.
I'm sure we will, officer. Now, if you could both just leave...
We're leaving, ma'am. Sorry for your loss. I can see what a tough time you're having with all this.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Any messages?
Just one, Detective, from the coroner. Message reads, Phelps, see me at Central Morgue immediately. Results of the Patterson autopsy.
Thanks for your help.
It's him, the cop from the newspaper.
Wow, that sure looks like a beauty.
We'll slaughter no more cattle or chicken. That is skin.
I'm sorry, sir. Police officer.
I need the gun in the glove compartment to shoot you.
Can you drive to this one?
I gotta have it. Never get into fights with ugly people. They have nothing to lose.
We can put the driver in front of a judge in less than a week.
You'd be making a big mistake.
Run that by me again?
The victim was dead before the car hit him. Two puncture wounds to the right side of the thorax. Second puncture reached his heart.
You're kidding me.
Been doing this job 23 years, son. No one's ever laughed at one of my jokes.
He was stabbed to death?
Long, sharp knife. Length of a bayonet.
We found a knife in the alleyway.
Where is it now? Was it bagged?
By Patrolman Kaplan.
Perfect. I'll get you a definite match.
Jesus, we got him. Murder one. We were right there and they tried to stare us down. Now they'll both get the gas chamber. We have the knife, we have the coroner's report, and I bet we could roll Sabo as a witness. Let's bring her in. Spoken to the coroner, Mrs. Patterson. He confirmed your husband's cause of death. We'd like you to come downtown and answer some questions.
It wasn't me. It was Leroy's idea. Leroy stabbed him. I had nothing to do with it.
Where is Leroy now?
He's in the bedroom.
You're very good, Lorna.
Put the gun down, Leroy. If you do something stupid now, you don't stand a chance in front of the grand jury.
Nice of you to give me up, sweetheart. All that whispering in my ear, telling me how we had to get rid of him, how good it could be, all the money we could claim, all that planning.
how to get him into the street, how to make it look like an accident.
For God's sake,
you
Leroy, shut up.
You had all the bases covered, baby.
I have nothing to do
you
with
think
it.
I'm going to fry for you,
He's
Lorna?
He's a crazy man. Shoot him. Shoot him, for God's sake.
It's too late, Sabo. Stop or I will shoot.
What are you, a linebacker?
You come any closer and I will pull the trigger.
Put the weapon down now.
Help me.
You look spooked, Phelps. I thought you'd been under fire before.
It never gets any easier, Bukowski.
So, I give you a hit and run, you bring me back fraud, conspiracy, and first-degree murder. This is how a good detective operates, Phelps. You take nothing at face value. You keep digging and asking questions until you get to the truth. You got some sharp elbows on you, detective. I like that. Keep up the good work.